Sawadee ka. Welcome to Thailand Large, and you're here with me, Abel Wanamakog. In this travel program, we're going to teach you the history, culture, lifestyles, and the many fun and amazing activities that you can do around Thailand. And today, I'm here at the Prince of Songkhla University's brand new terminal. Now, many of you might not know this, but Phuket is a very, very popular place in Asia to travel to. This place has more and more people coming every year, and now we're reaching almost 7 million passengers coming to Phuket a year, just to Phuket. And the Prince of Songkhla University have just recently opened their own terminal, which is a cabin flight simulator that teaches their students how to become better ground staff and how to be flight attendants, shall they wish to continue on into that profession. And I'm very excited to see this because I never thought that I can have a chance to fly on the ground. And it seems like we're going to be going to Bangkok today in the PSU airline with the PSU terminal, which just recently opened. So let's go check out what they have, and maybe your students and your kids who want to study here and learn about tourism and hospitality later on. So let's go check it out. Sawadee ka. Very nice to meet you, Colin. Thank you so much for welcoming me here today. And I know you have a very long title, so I'll let you introduce yourself to all the viewers.
Okay, I'm the chairman for the tourism management program for the Faculty of Hospitality and Tourism in Prince of Songkhla University.
Excellent. I know this is a very, very new terminal.
Yep.
And you call this the PSU terminal?
That's right.
And you have your own airline.
As well as our own airport.
Wow, wow, and this is brand new, isn't it?
Yeah, we got this completed around April this year.
In April this year. Wow, well, I think our viewers and all the people that are traveling here to Thailand love brand new things,
yeah.
Especially myself, and I feel very privileged to be able to come here because this is normally not open to the public, is that correct?
Not yet. We will start classes for the coming term, which is this August. So we just started class this term, which is several days ago. And the first in-flight service class will start pretty soon, which will be the end of this week.
Wow. And the reason I'm sure that you built this is because it's very, very popular amongst your students, isn't it?
That's right. Yeah. As what we can see, a majority of Thai students wants to be flight attendants. They want to work for airlines, work for different positions within the airline industry. That's why we built this facility so that we can get them equipped, get them ready for the future career.
Let's stop talking and please show me around. So
sure.
Am I going to be on your plane today?
Yes, you will be.
Where am I flying to?
I will be flying to Bangkok.
Okay.
Going back to Bangkok.
All right.
All right. So, this is our check-in counter.
Business class.
We do have two different classes, business class and premium pro. So the check-in counters allow the student to get prepared to be ground service agent for at an airport for airlines. So they will know how to check in, how to provide customer service. And most importantly, it's about how to interact, how to resolve problem that the customer has.
Should I give your students some problems right now?
Sure. Just go ahead.
Well, hi. What's going on? I'm just joking. Sawadee ka, I'm going to Bangkok today. I did not buy a ticket yet. Can you prepare a ticket for me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. All right, Colin. So what is next?
Next, we will go to the boarding gate.
Excellent.
This way, please.
Thank you.
Attention, please, attention. Waiting for Mr. Colin. And Mrs. Abel for PSU Airline Flight PS123. Phuket to Bangkok. Please identify yourself to gate number 43. Gate number 43 immediately. Thank you.
All right, so let's go with this.
Thank you.
Now, here are our
This is so real.
Attendants.
Oh, hello. Sawadee ka. Nice to meet you.
Nice
working
meet
hard
you.
Today?
Yes.
Yes.
So all these extras are your students, right?
Yes, those are all the students.
Excellent.
This is the fourth year student.
This is really real.
Yeah.
Wow. So everything, okay, so everything can be used.
Everything is used. Actually, a lot of those equipment are real aircraft equipment. We just got this from Thai Airways. This facility is certified by Thai Flight Training Association Academy, Thai Flight Training Academy, which we can do actual proper in-flight service training for Thai Airways as well.
So you have like a food cart, and then you have beverage carts.
That's right.
And we have a trash can.
Trash can. We do have coffee maker. I guess every time when you take a flight, you will always see something like this.
Yes.
This is the real container for food items.
And this Where do you get all these things?
This is the setup from Thai Airways.
Oh, this is really, really interesting.
So you always see flight attendants closing the containers, and that's the sound. That's captain.
The captain. Wow, my honor to meet you.
This is our cabin, the main cabin of this aircraft. We do have 4 business class seats and 36 economic class seats. Basically, that will be the size of our class. Normally, a normal size of our class is around 40 students.
What aircraft is this modeled for?
This is a 737-800 aircraft model. We try to make it as real as possible, so all the measurements are in real. Yes, this is real ratio, 1-to-1 ratio.
So this is one of those rare moments where I could sit in business class, which I don't get to do very often, and thanks to Colin today.
Oh, you're welcome.
I know I'm going to get excellent service on your PSU airline.
Yep.
Now, just tell me a little bit, because I want to see the actions and things like that. I mean, this must be one of the most popular classes that you have.
Yes, basically, as I told you before, a lot of Thai students, especially, as even though we are an international program, but a majority of our students are Thai, and they love to study something related. Oh, firstly, they love to study something really practical,
right,
so that they can really use them in the future. And secondly, a lot of them wants to work for airlines in the future. That's why a lot of them choose this class.
Seatbelt has been inside for 2 buttons.
So as you can see, this is a real meal.
That's right.
Can I open this?
Yes.
I can open this. Wow. So you actually prepare all the food by yourself?
We do have a restaurant here.
Wow.
So we will have, as I've told you, we try to do everything as real as possible. So the meal will be real as well. We are incorporated with TFTA, Thai Flight Training Academy. So after the students study the some courses here, the customer service course, the in-flight service management course, they can proceed to Thai Airways and then complete the full course and then get the cabin crew license as well.
Wow, so it seems like your students like already have a career. If they take this course and they follow through and they do what they're supposed to do, then they have a job.
And they get ahead of a lot of other students in Thailand, ahead of other people.
Well, I'm full now.
So, I think we have arrived Bangkok.
Okay.
So, let's get up.
It was a quick flight.
That's right. Okay.
Thank you.
So, let's go out through the back door. I would like to show you something very interesting.
Excellent.
So actually, we do have an emergency exit door here, which we can open. This is a part of training as well to let the student know how aircraft doors are operating. But the mechanism is not real. However, we try to make it as real as possible. So on an actual aircraft, the door is actually moving outward like this. So just push and then the door will go that way.
Very nice. Very nice. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Kabunha.
So we're back to the airport.
Well, I had a great flight. I mean, I really felt like I was on an airplane.
Thank you. And yes.
Wow, I mean, this is wonderful. I love the experiences that we're having here. I really wish all your students good luck with their training, starting next month?
No, the end of this week.
End of this week?
Yeah, the end of this week. Okay. Actually, they will, I think they look forward for this course as well. This is the very first time that we do it here.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much, Colin.
Thank you.
For your time today and for showing me your PSU terminal. And for our viewers out there, I just want to let you know that this is only a simulator. And obviously, there are a lot of real activities that are happening around Phuket and around Thailand. And the next time that we're going to go show you, we're going to show you a real airport. So stay tuned.
How do you do?
I'm good. Hello.
Welcome.
I'm Abel.
Yeah, welcome, Kun Abel,
to
the Phuket Airpark.
Nice to meet you. What is your name, sir?
Suchat Raksangop, Kap.
Sawadee ka, Kun Suchat.
Sawadee ka. Welcome to the airpark.
Welcome.
I'd like to introduce you to my assistant, Kun M.
Hello.
Kun Abel.
Kun M, nice to meet you.
And this is Kun Pat James from Texas.
Very nice to meet you.
Pat is our safety and operation manager at this place.
Okay. Excellent. You're also the pilot, I heard.
That's correct, and we're here to make sure you have a nice, safe, fun day.
Excellent. I'm very excited. I'm looking forward to it, and I'm looking to learn a lot about the Phuket Airpark and what you guys do here. And please tell me, what are we going to do today, Mr.
I will walk you to the planes, introduce you, show you what we have.
Excellent.
And then later you will be flying.
Okay, excellent. Sounds great. So I follow you.
Okay, let's go.
And I understand you are the owner of the airport, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, and you have a lot of different types of aircrafts here.
Yes, we have fixed wing, two seats, four seats and six seats airplane, and also the latest addition is now a gyroplane.
Oh wow, really?
We call it with love the little bumblebee.
Oh, I look forward to seeing it. And I just want to ask, I mean, can everybody come here?
Of course, yes.
They can.
We welcome, yes.
Just a quick question. Besides the airplanes, you do have some other activity as well, is that correct?
Oh, airplane is our activity.
Airplane is your activity?
Yes, and it is for us the adventure. And in Thailand, you can own your own airplane. You can go to learn to fly.
Yes.
You can also skydiving.
Wow.
And you also can own a private airport.
Really?
So everything is legal and everything is possible in Thailand.
Wow.
The sky is all
the sky is not the limit. Is that correct?
That's correct, yes.
Excellent.
And then there's another, that is a STOL, we call it the Sky Jeep.
STOL Sky Jeep.
Yes, STOL is a short takeoff, short landing airplane. And there are two of them in white and in red.
Okay. And I see now.
To your right will be here, it's a six-seater.
A big
one. Piper Cherokee.
Robert, please tell me, I heard that you have a new aircraft.
That's right.
So can you show me that?
Yes, yes.
I'm very excited.
If you would turn around, this is the yellow bumblebee. It's a very nice, cute, it's the latest edition we have.
Look at this thing.
It's a gyro cropter. the specialist is here, Kun Best.
Oh, thank you.
And I'd like to introduce you, Kun Best.
Thank you very much.
Abel.
Sawadee Kun Best.
Sawadee Kap.
Very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Thank you very much for your time and for showing me your aircraft today. And I just want to say thank you so much to Kun Su Chad.
Sawadee Kap. And have a nice day.
Time.
And also nice flying.
I see that you have a really, really nice looking aircraft. It looks very different from the other ones. And Kun Su Cha told me that this is a gyrocopter.
Sure. Gyrocopter.
Please tell me a little because I really have no idea what is a gyrocopter.
Sure. Gyrocopter is a hybrid between a fixed wing aircraft and a helicopter aircraft. The main difference is the rotor that you see here is a power by engine like in helicopter. But it actually rotates by itself in auto-rotation mode when the wind hits it from below. So it's like you have a leaf coming down from the tree. So it's unpowered rotor. But it still have the
propeller
prop on the back as a pusher type to push the plane forward. So this is the power and this is the lift.
So now I'm going to take your suggestion and look inside. Shall we take a look inside?
Sure.
Where should I sit?
Have a seat right here.
Okay.
Yes. Wash your feet.
Thank you.
Go around it.
The seat's very comfortable. I mean, this is a private aircraft, obviously. I have been on fixed wings before. I have been on a helicopter before. But I've never been on a gyrocopter before.
Yeah, okay. You got a stick with a cyclic control.
All right.
And simply put, faster, slower, left and right.
Okay. Well, you make it sound very easy.
Yeah. Forward is make it faster, mm-hmm. slower, pull it back toward you, left and right. This is a throttle. This is just like a boat. This is more gas, less gas. This is a brake. You do the brake on the wheels, for the wheels on the ground. It's only throttle, control sticks, and all this instrument, let me run it by you a little bit. This is just an engine instrument. You have like the temperature, the fuel gauge, how hot is the oil. Is everything in a green arc, then you're okay. Here is an engine RPM, just like in a car, oil temperature. This is a rotor RPM. So this is just kind of warning. If you see it's in green, it's fine. Okay. GPS. And here you come to the flight instrument, which is three things, very simple. Airspeed indicator, how fast it's going, just like in a car. Altimeter, how high you're going above ground.
Okay.
This is like a clock, you know, long arms, short arms, 100 feet, 200 feet, 300 feet. When you go one round, then the short arms go after one, so it's 1,000 feet. And then this is the vertical speed. See how fast you climb and how fast you descend. So if it stays at zero, it means you're in level flight.
The equipment and the plane and things like that. And now I can't wait to actually go and fly. And I heard that you have your pilots ready for me so I can have a ride.
Sure.
Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay. So thank you so much, Kun Best. Well, I'm here with Pat, the pilot of the gyrocopter today, and I'm very excited because I've never flown on this before. And I'm going to let him do most of the talking and tell me what I need to do before I go up on the plane. So, Pat?
Well, one of the very first things we want to do is just make sure your life vest is secured. We look generally at the aircraft and give you a little safety briefing. Our seats inside the aircraft are extremely comfortable. They contour to you. We have the doors open so you can actually enjoy the flying.
Also, this usually has a door.
Usually we can have a door on there, but in the tropics and flying for photographics and for enjoyment, it is by far, this is the only way to travel.
It's like, what do you call it, a convertible for a plane.
It is a convertible, and we're in the tropics, so we should have a convertible at all times.
So sounds good. Let's get this going right now, and while the sun is still out, let's go. Thank you very much, Pat.
Look forward to it.
All right. Woo. think this is great for people who love adventures and people who love to do just very different things, don't you think?
This is not only just adventures, it's just seeing something new, opening new doors that people have never had an opportunity to see before.
I'm sure that, I mean, I don't have a lot of opportunity to see Phuket from the skies, but this is a great opportunity, and I'm sure it's going to look really amazing from up there.
The view from up high, even from 500 feet or 1,000 feet, is spectacular. Parts of Phuket Island you've never seen before from the road make it ideal.
Wow. Okay, well, I'm not going to distract you anymore. I'm going to let you do your flying, and anytime you want to say anything to me, just let me know. I'm gonna enjoy the ride.
Please do. Sit back and enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
We're going to go down and take off on the 13 runway, head towards the ocean.
Excellent, excellent. This is something that you have to do when you come to Phuket. It's not very expensive, it's very affordable. You want to do something different, you want to do something that is just way out there, and you want to see Phuket in a totally different way. This is the way to do it, and I would choose this over just flying a normal airplane, but it's because I've flown on a normal airplane before. It's just so different, and I have to say thank you so much to our pilot Pat for such an amazing ride. Thank you.
You're very welcome, and please hurry back. We're having too much fun out here.
This is just great. I mean, I cannot say anything more. Awesome, great. The experience is awesome, and now it's your turn to come and fly with us next time. So please come again and take a look at what Phuket and the Phuket Airpark has to offer. The viewers out there who are foreigners or Thais, coming here to Thailand, most of the time we don't think about doing things like flying, but before I came here, I never even thought about flying, and I never even thought that I can afford to fly. But after meeting Suchat and Pat and Khun Bes, and understanding more that it is affordable to do this, to learn to fly, it makes me feel more comfortable. And after the ride with Pat earlier, I mean, I just feel amazing. I feel exhilarated, and I hope that all the people who are coming here to Thailand, or who are people who are living here in Thailand, come to see the Phuket Airpark. And for those who want to learn to fly, of course you can fly at the simulator at the Phuket Songkhla University, or why not come to Phuket Airpark and learn to fly in a real airplane such as one of these, or fly one of these here and see for yourself. And I just want to say thank you so much for watching today's show, Thailand at Large. My name is Abel Wanamakok. I really hope you enjoyed today, and hope to see you soon. Sawadee ha.